Yeah, it's the camera. Last time I took Rowan here, who's my 13-year-old. I think she was 11 at the time. I don't know. Now I'm taking the 15-year-old, Sydney. She absolutely abhors going outside. And just like the wife doesn't like bugs. So we just met Lauren from the Forest Service. They're fixing to do a lot of construction, so the whole place is closed. So we've got, I think we saw two other people. So we got the whole summit to ourselves. I hope they had really looked to be day hikers, so I don't think they're gonna spend a night. So Sydney and I have the whole thing to ourselves. It, assuming she doesn't get eaten alive, she's gross. So we're gonna spend one night. I got two hammocks. I don't know which one she wants. I'm concerned if she sleeps in the bridge. She's like this when she sleeps, so she might fall out. So that was a good point. Got burgers for her because that's the only thing she eats. And my mom and my stepfather gave me a steak. So we got that for me. No Albus, because although it's going to be maybe 61, 50s at night, I'm really worried that, you know, the 90-degree, 80-degree weather was just too hot for him, even if it rains around 4. So it would have been good for her, but we'll bring him out in the fall. So yeah, we're at Mount Pleasant. We're going to stay here for one night. Is that you screaming?
Yes.
I thought it was like a bird or a dog.
I'm sorry. Oh, are you looking at the baby ones?
Yeah, really small. Little blood. No CMs.
There's two more.
They're eating you alive, kiddo.
Is he leaving?
So over there, you can't see it now, but over there is nothing but these type of mountains. No houses, no radio towers, and it goes on for miles. And like, it's just, at night, it's pitch black. And like, yeah. Yeah. Whoa. You talk about adventure. So the trail to the spring is so overgrown, I can't even see it. So I'm gonna have to go bushwhack through this with my compass. You know, adventure's supposed to be fun. This is nuts. It's raining. Okay, I found the trail. You can see on the ground, but you can't see it there. And if you go back there, it's like, what? But you can use that dead tree as a guide. So, yeah. See? There it is. This is insane. Oh, jeez. And there's the spring. Yeah, see the trail? So usually, if this is too stagnant, right? It's like not thick enough. Then what you can do is you follow it downstream, and there's a stream down there. The issue is that this is so overgrown. I'm not sure how I'm supposed to get through this. I'm tempted just to use this. I'm gonna try with the life straw and then see if I can't. I don't know what I'm gonna do. That's the fun of it, right? 305 north-ish is the way back. I found the stream that I camped next to, and it is just, you know, as you can see, a jungle, an absolute jungle, but I can use my compass to get back. So down here is a drop where it funnels all this water to a little waterfall right there. Yep. And so that's where I can really get a lot of water because it's very deep and cleaner than most. So, oh, geez. That's what we'll use. We'll use this. A lot of bugs, but it's moving.
Rolling around.
It looks like a mole or a bull.
Oh, can we take him home?
No, he's injured, baby.
Oh.
So it was your first backpacking trip. You slept in a hammock, you hiked in insane humidity, and you were in camp in torrential downpour. How was it?
Pretty good.
Pretty good? That's it? That's all you have to say? Pretty good?
Hate, and then like there's a part of it I love, but there's no in between. It's either you hate or you love it.